Hello students, let us continue with the problems in Cauchy's root test in this video. Let us take the fifth one. Test for convergence of the series 1 plus x by 2, x square by 3 square, x cube by 4 cube plus etc. up to infinity. If the question is just test for convergence, you can go for both D'Alembert's ratio test or Cauchy's root test. Since we are doing the Cauchy's root test, so I will go for the Cauchy's root test method. Here, I will neglect the first term. I have already told you, n always starts from 1. So that is why if I take 1, it is of the form x to the power 0. So I neglect it. We will take from the second term onwards. If you compare x to the power 1, x to the power 2, x to the power 3, so x to the power 4, x to the power 5, it goes on and the last term would be x to the power n. Because in the powers we have 1, 2, 3, 4 which are natural number. If you see the denominator, if power is 1, the base of the numerator is 1 more, 2. If your power is 2, the base is 3. 2, 3. 3, 4. 4, 5. 5, 6. It goes on. So, n, 1 more than n. That is, n plus 1. Now, you see the power in the denominator. Here, 2 to the power 1, 3 to the power 2, 4 to the power 3. It is increasing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the power here becomes x to the power n, n plus 1 to the power n. That's it. That is how we write the un. Now according to Cauchy's root test, limit of n tends to infinity un to the power 1 by n is equal to limit of n tends to infinity. When I take the power 1 by n, n cancels with 1 by n and we get x by n plus 1. When we apply the limit, it is of the form x by, when n, since n is infinity, x by infinity, which is 1 by infinity is 0. So it becomes 0. 0 is less than 1. Hence, sigma un is convergent by Cauchy's root test. So Cauchy's root test is very simple when compared to D'Alembert's ratio test. Test the convergence of the series sigma log n to the power minus 2n. Un we have taken it as log of log n to the power minus 2n. Let us take un to the power 1 by n as limit of n tends to infinity. It becomes limit of n tends to infinity log n to the power minus 2n whole to the power 1 by n. So n cancels here. So we get log n to the power minus 2. So since the power is minus 2, it will come to the denominator 1 by log n square. When I apply the limit, it becomes 1 by log infinity to the power. So log infinity is infinity. 1 by infinity is nothing but 0. Therefore here also again the value of the limit when we apply the limit is 0. Which is really less than 1. Hence by Cauchy's root test sigma un is convergent. I have already told you the problems in Cauchy's root test is very easy when compared to D'Alembert's ratio test. Here within 4-5 steps you get the answer, whereas in D'Alembert's it will take more than 8-9 steps. Next, discuss the convergence of the series sigma n plus 1 to the power n into x to the power n by n to the power n plus 1. Un we will take n plus 1 to the power n x to the power n by n to the power n plus 1. Now let us apply the Cauchy's root test limit of n tends to infinity u to the power 1 by n. When I take derive the same thing and take the power 1 by n, each one we can divide by 1 by n. So n plus 1, x to the power n by 1 by n, n get cancelled. So we will get x. Here n to the power n plus 1 divided by n. So it will be n to the power 1 plus 1 by n. Each term I divide by n. N by n becomes 1, 1 by n. Next, what we have to do is, I'll split the denominator. N plus 1, this I can split n into n to the power half. So n plus 1 by n, I have taken it as one term. 1 by n to the power 1 by n I have written separately into x. Now we have the standard form, limit of n tends to infinity n to the power 1 by n is 1. So in the denominator n to the power 1 by n is there, as n tends to infinity, so the value of this whole thing becomes 1. So what remains is limit of n tends to infinity n plus 1 by n into x remains. To simplify, I have taken n common. Anyhow, n is there in the denominator. Numerator becomes 1 plus 1 by n. N get cancelled. And when I apply the limit, 1 plus 1 by infinity into x. 1 by infinity is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 into x is x. Here also, the convergence or the divergence of the sequence depends upon the value of x. So, as we have already done, it has three possibilities. One possibility, when x is less than 1, the series is convergent. When x is greater than 1, the series is divergent. What if x is equal to 1? Let us see. When x is equal to 1, we get only the remaining terms. The remaining terms is, okay, not done here. So I'll give it as a homework. You check it and let me know what you get when x is equal to 1. I'll just tell you what you get. So you will apply the necessary rule for the positive series. So that will be convergent if you apply the limit un as n tends to infinity. If you get the answer as 0, it is convergent. If it is not equal to 0, it is divergent. Just put x is equal to 1 in the given un and check whether it is convergent or divergent. Let us move on to the next problem. Discuss the nature of the series 3 by 4 into x, 4 by 5 into x square, 4 by 5 whole square into x square, plus 5 by 6 whole cube into x cube, plus it goes on up to infinity. So here the power is equal to 1. Power of x is also equal to 1. So let us first take, to write un, I'll consider the x and its power. X to the power 1, x to the power 2, x to the power 3, x to the power 4, x to the power 5, it goes on, it becomes x to the power n, written here. Now compare the power with the numerator. If 1, it is, numerator is 3, that is 2 more. 1 plus 2 is 3. Here if you see, the power is 2, numerator is 4, that is 2 plus 2 is 4. Here power is 3, numerator is 5, 3 plus 2 is 5. So every time 2 is being added. So if power is n, the numerator should be n plus 2. Compare the denominator. 1 plus 3 gives 4. Here the power is 2. 2 plus 3 gives 5. Here the power is 3. 3 plus 3 gives 6. Power is n. N plus 3 gives the denominator. And all the powers again have a, all the, sorry, the fraction has again the power. The power is 1, 2, 3, 4, which is again a natural number. So n plus 2 by n plus 3 to the power n into x to the power n. The whole result of the problem depends upon how you write the un. The important step is writing the un. If you write un properly, it is very easy to apply the limit and get the answer. So learn finding un first in all the problems. Now let us apply the Cauchy's root test. According to the Cauchy's root test, limit of n tends to infinity un to the power 1 by n is equal to limit of n tends to infinity n plus 2 by n plus 3 to the power n into x to the power n whole to the power n. When each term you divide by 1 by n, you get limit of n tends to infinity n plus 2 by n plus 3 into x. So to apply the limit, it will be of the form infinity by infinity. So I have to take n common here. So it becomes 1 plus 2 by n. If I take n common in the denominator, 1 plus 3 by n into x. N cancels. If I apply the limit, this term becomes 0. So 1 into x, it becomes x. So as in all the previous problems, here also there are three possibilities of x. One possibility, when x is less than 1, the series is convergent. When x is greater than 1, the series is divergent. And when x is equal to 1, we'll take the un here. When x is equal to 1, 1 to the power n is 1 only. We will get n plus 2 by n plus 3 to the power n. That is what we have taken here. Now to simplify, we will go for the necessary property for the power series to be convergent. So limit of un as n tends to infinity. To apply the limits, again n we have taken common here. When n is taken common, 1 plus 2 by n whole to the power n. Denominator n is taken common, 1 plus 3 by n whole to the power n. N get cancelled. If you see the numerator, it is of the standard form limit of n tends to infinity 1 plus x by n to the power n, which is nothing but e to the power x. So in the place of x we have 2 here, so it will be e square. In the place of x we have 3 here, so it is e cube. E square by e cube is 1 by e, which is not equal to 0. Therefore by Cauchy's root, therefore by the necessary condition of the positive term, it is un is divergent. If it is equal to 0, then it is convergent. So let us summarize it. Sigma un is convergent for x less than 1. Sigma un is divergent for x greater than or equal to 1. This is how we get the answer. So I hope you have understood all the problems. So few more problems are left in Cauchy's root test. Let us learn those problems in the next video. Thank you.